Hi kids, welcome to Kiddie Kitchen. I am your host, Chef Patrick. On every episode, we'll be showcasing a star ingredient. For today's show, our star ingredient is eggs.
Eggs are highly nutritious and loaded with vitamins and nutrients. Vitamin B2 is abundant in the egg white. It is involved in vital metabolic processes in the body.
Today, I am joined by my guest chef, and he will introduce himself.
Hi everyone, my name is Chef Enron.
So, the first rule when it comes to the kitchen is that we must always wash our hands before we start doing anything. So the first thing I'm going to do with Chef Enron is that we are going to wash our hands. We have already washed our hands. So for today, we are going to make a dish by the name egg sandwich. For the egg sandwich, we will need a number of ingredients. So Chef Eldon will help me assist in naming the ingredients. So first of all, we have
white onions,
followed by
tomatoes,
then
colored peppers,
and then
the lettuce.
So for the lettuce, we had to remove it from the bulb and then wash one leaf at a time. Next we have
slices of bread,
then
boiled eggs,
then
ham,
and then
salt,
and then
pepper.
Now that we've already shown you our ingredients, we are ready to prepare our egg sandwich. But before we prepare our egg sandwich, we had to clean our ingredients, and this is how we clean. Now that we've already finished washing our ingredients, we are going to assemble our egg sandwich. So for the preparation, we are going to start with cutting all our ingredients that we need for the sandwich. So to begin with, we have the onions. I am going to take one onion and give to my assistant chef, Edlon, and I'm going to use one. So when it comes to actually in the kitchen, you have to be very careful with handling knives, especially with kids, because you don't know what might happen. So Chef Eldon, when you want to cut an onion, because it's a sandwich,
yeah,
you want to cut it as onion rings.
Yeah.
So okay. For onion rings, mm-hmm. you just put it like this.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And then you just slice. Make sure that your hands are far from the knife so that you don't cut yourself.
Okay.
So you just cut slices. Round slices like that. Yeah, just continue cutting. So I think we have enough onions for our sandwiches. Then we can move to our next ingredient. So, hello, you can give me your onions so that you can be more cooked. Next, we have our tomatoes. So I'm going to pick one and hand one to the Eldon. And for the tomatoes, we're also going to cut them into rings. So you have first to remove the top of the tomato, like this. Always remember to be careful with your knife. Yeah. Yeah, so you can give it this one. And then we cut them as onion rings. So the same way we did with the onions. Let's just cut them into rings. Yeah. For the rings, always ensure that they are not too thick. They are just a sizable amount so that it's not too much on a person, or rather on an individual. Yeah, they look, maybe you can add one other ring. Yeah, it looks very, very nice, very good.
Okay, Chef, I have a question.
Yeah.
Does the number of rings that you cut depend on the number of sandwiches that you're going to cook?
Definitely. You have to look at the number so that you don't cut too much tomatoes,
yeah,
for your sandwiches. Now next, we have our peppers. We have the orange and the red. Elon, I don't know which one is your favorite color between the two.
Okay, then pick the red one.
Okay, there you go. Okay, now we are going to put our tomatoes back to our plate. So there we have our tomatoes back. Then, next we have our peppers. So for the peppers, we also have to cut them into rings. So when it comes to peppers, you have to remove, to deseed the pepper. So this is what you do, everyone. You just put the knife like this. Just be careful with the knife. Just do around the slowly. Just, yeah. Yeah. Yes, and then we remove all the seeds. They are in there, the seeds.
Of course, they are.
Yeah, please remove all the seeds because we don't have ones to test the seeds. Let me show you how to remove. Okay, we have to remove the seeds. So in this case, I'll assist Elon to remove the seeds because his peppers are not. The seeds are not coming out, but now we have a pepper which is actually does not have seeds, so there you go, Elon. Yeah, thank you. Always remember to keep your surfaces clean so that you avoid any accidents that may arise.
Okay, are pepper seeds maybe harmful?
No, they are not harmful, but we want the sandwich to actually have to not have the seeds. They're not harmful in any way, but they are. It's just like we may choose them, but they'll just maybe untidy our sandwich. So we just remove them. But if a person likes them, they can still eat them. We want to actually get the taste of the pepper itself, as opposed to the seeds. Yeah. So we want now to slice our peppers. So we are still going to slice them as rings. Yeah, so for the peppers, we'll put the same way and then we'll slice. Yeah. Make sure that you actually have thin, sizable slices. Yeah, and one thing you will notice with peppers have a very sweet taste. So I will recommend anyone at home to be using peppers to their dishes. It really adds to the flavor and it has a very sweet taste. Especially the colored peppers, as opposed to the green peppers, they are more mature and hence the sweeter taste. So always be careful with the knife, make sure that you actually watch for your fingers. Yeah. I think now this is enough. Elon has done a very good job. He's cut the peppers. We have the orange peppers and the red peppers. And we can use this one another time. Okay, we are going to put all the peppers that we cut in one dish so that we'll use them when assembling our sandwich. And then next we have our lettuce. For the lettuce, they already are good size, so we'll just assemble them in the sandwich. Just layer them on the egg. Any question, Elon?
No, not for now,
yeah. Next we have our eggs. So I'll give Elon an egg, then I'll take another one, and then we'll remove the shells for the eggs. Yeah. No, don't use the knife. Just hit it on the table, yeah. Yeah. And then just remove it, just peel off the skin. For eggs, what you can remember, that don't overcook your eggs. Always cook them with the right amount of time, and so that you avoid them being black.
Chef, you have to tell us how do you do them and what is the right amount of time. You are the one teaching.
When it comes to cooking the eggs, always ensure that you cook them, you boil your water first. After boiling your water, you place the eggs in the boiling water for 5 minutes, and then you turn off from the heat. Then after that, you are going to let them remain in the pot for another 10 minutes, and then you can now remove them from the pot.
Chef, I have a question.
Yeah.
Is there any reason you leave them in the pot for some time?
Yeah, the reason is, when it comes to eggs, for the 5 minutes, the egg is not fully cooked. So if you remove it from the pot, it will actually be runny. So you are letting them remain in the pot for another 10 minutes so that you ensure it's actually fully cooked. Yeah. Now we have our egg. So for the egg, we are also going to slice it as rings so that when you're assembling our sandwich, it actually resembles all the other ingredients we have prepared. So we can cut the eggs. Now that we have finished cutting our eggs, we are going to take a short commercial break.
National Educator.
Welcome back to Kiddie Kitchen. Before the break, we have prepared our ingredients for the egg sandwich. Now we are going to assemble the egg sandwich. So to assemble the egg sandwich, we are going to start with our bread. So I'm going to pick a slice of bread and put in my plate. Then I'll give Eldon another slice. And then we are going to start with the onions first. So we'll pick a few onions. Eldon can take some few onions. And just assemble them on the plate. Yeah, don't put too much onions, otherwise we just want our sandwich to be a sizable amount which a person can actually take and eat. Yeah, that's good enough. Then next we are going to take some tomatoes. So I'll take some tomatoes. You take two. Yeah. You just put them across like that. Right? Just across, yeah. Just put them across like that. Then next, we are going to take our eggs and just put them.
Okay, so we ask, is it necessary to assemble them the way we are?
No, there's actually no formula towards assembling an egg. You can pick here, you can just pick that egg. There's actually no formula towards assembling an egg. We just want to make sure that we have put them in the correct way so that we actually have all the ingredients in the plate. So there's actually, you can start with whatever you want, whatever you like mostly, and as you assemble your egg sandwich. Now at this point in time, you're actually going to take 2 pinches of salt and 2 pinches of pepper. You're just trying to add flavor to the eggs. So I'll just take one pinch first, and drizzle all over. And another one.
Please warn again over salting food.
Yeah, always remember not to put too much salt. Just a pinch, just like this. And just put another one. Make sure that the ingredients which didn't have salt have now the salt. And now next we are going to go to the pepper. So just take a pinch, just a small pinch, because pepper sometimes might be overpowering and some people don't. Just a pinch like that, right? And just all over the sandwich, right? Yeah. Next, we are going to add our peppers. So just to make the plate look colorful, we are just going to do intervals of orange and red. So just take two of orange first. Yeah, just put them diagonal. Then take two of red, just put them the other side. And always remember that peppers, they are really healthy, and the green peppers, as I already said, are not mostly preferred for salads and sandwiches. Preferably, colored peppers are better because of the sweet taste and they are more mature. So you can take another layer just to, you can interchange now. See, we started with the orange, now with the orange over the red. Yeah, like that. Just put it over here and here. And now we put the red. And I see our sandwich is actually starting to build up, and it's already looking delicious. Does it look delicious?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, so next we'll go to the ham. Ham sandwich. Just take a slice and put it over.
Nice.
Yeah. And then now, as we finish the sandwich, we are going to finish with the lettuce. So we can pick one. So we are just going to place the lettuce over the sandwich. What branch of lettuce can do for the sandwich? Because the sandwich, as you can see, is not too big. It's just a small amount. Yeah? I think yours is looking nice as it is. Now we are going to finish off our sandwich by covering it with the other slice. So I'll pick a slice and give you the end on the slice. Then we'll cover our sandwich. And there we have our sandwich.
There we have it, our egg sandwich. It's a very simple and easy dish to make, as you have seen. I have been your host, Chef Patrick, with
Chef Elon, his assistant.
See you next week on Kiddie Kitchen. Bye!
Educator.